The key to your success in sales is setting up the right sales process visually in your sales pipeline. So let's see how this works in Pipedrive. Now your pipeline is filled with these tiles here, which are your deals. Deals represent sales conversations for your contacts that are in a specific stage of your sales process. You can have as many deals open for the same contact person or organization as you'd like, and the pipeline view will easily give you a visual overview of the overall performance and status of your sales team. A good sales pipeline is a proven way of speeding up deal closing while ensuring that no deals fall through the cracks. So basically, whenever a sales rep logs into Pipedrive, they can see all deals they own and where they're at. As they go about their day, they'll schedule and perform various sales activities that help them close deals. Better yet, Pipedrive automatically shuffles deals to the top of your list that have an activity that's overdue or due today. That means you'll always know what deals to focus on the moment you log in. Pretty simple but effective. But so all these stages here, you may want to customize these, right? To set up your pipeline, just go to Pipeline Settings where you can edit the stages. You can also add multiple pipelines which can contain different stages to reflect different processes. And if you'd like, this here is Deal Rotting, which notifies you if a deal sits a little too long in your pipeline without anything happening to it, and it'll highlight these deals in red. And the Deal Probability feature allows you to kind of better forecast the revenue you're expecting to bring in. So let's say, for instance, I figure that only 80% of the deals that are in the first stage of my pipeline are likely to be won. I can set that up here, and the weighted values will be available in the pipeline views and various other metrics throughout Pipedrive. Both features can be set up on a per-stage basis. So now let's say you're done setting up your pipeline, or pipelines. Awesome, right? So now at this point, your major goal is to get those deals to the last stage of your pipeline and win them. But you know, sometimes you just can't win them all, and some deals are lost. When deals are lost, you can specify why exactly, and this will be available in your reports later. Makes it much easier to evolve. You can also pre-program lost reasons for sales reps to select from in advance or allow users to write their own lost reasons. You can also drag deals to other pipelines and pass the deal along to another process, for example, and you can switch to those different pipelines in this dropdown right here. Once deals are won, you can always use your filters to see your won deals, and you can schedule activities and move them along the pipelines even after they've been won. You just need to have the right filter in place to see them. And speaking of filters, these filters here make it real easy to see specific sales reps' deals or everyone's deals, or you can customize a more complex filter to see really specific deals. So if you need to organize and speed up your sales process, a well-structured sales pipeline might be a good way to start.